Hello everyone, and welcome to Antidote Battle of the Stem Cell, a game developed by Scion Games. I'm Bonadena, and also Matt Bond, and I'm actually one of the developers of Scion Games, so I quite love this game. Today I'm going to play through level 1, 2, 4, just quickly running through how the game works for you all. Okay, so on the right here, this is the stem cell. We need to stop the enemies from getting here by building a variety of defenses. These are the white cells. They soak up the toxins which are coming, and I can also build them like this by tapping. And I'm going to stop them by building a lot of cell walls. Oh yeah, stem cells looking pretty happy. You can see the way that the enemy is moving around the level, so I can give them a bit longer route. Oh! Here we have a bacteria, I didn't even see him coming. So, he's not gonna go straight into my walls, he's giving off toxins. Harmless on his own, but quite toxic. So I'm gonna upgrade my defenses and eat that bacteria. There we go. Now, Antidote has two main resources. Cell walls, which the stem cell is constantly producing, and sugar. So this unit here generates me sugar. This level's pretty easy, I don't need it, but just introducing it now. And sugar is used to buy upgrades, like this guy here. Yes, new best. Okay, on to level 2. So here you see we've already got some units working for us, and those sugar generators I mentioned, they're running away in the back, so let's throw down some basic defenses to keep the enemy busy. Down here, in the bottom right, we have Sleepyhead. Sleepyhead is a really powerful unit when you combine it with sugar generators. Oh, yes! So, the sugar generators here, you'll see the sugar coming in now, and now. But these ones at the bottom, well, I can barely count the amount of sugar that's coming. So one of the most important things in beating Antidote the best way, getting the best scores, is to combine units and their effects. So let's go with another example here. Let's build my little cell. Now this is quite a late game unit, and what it does is it picks up enemies and it feeds them to the surrounding defenses. So these here would not normally be able to reach the enemy, but now they can. And I can continue to combine these. So here I have my basic slow field. Let's put two of these down here. The enemies coming through this gap are going to be going pretty slowly. And let's get more eaters down. Now, if I upgrade this slow field to the two helper cell, that's going to accelerate everyone around it. This guy is really one of my favourite units in the game. Combined with the big eater, the upgrade from the small eater, it'll get you through a lot of the levels. Definitely not all of them, but it's one of the ones on your side. Okay, looks like I'm gonna win. Make absolutely sure of it. Okay, on to level 3. Now, if you're playing along with me at home, you might notice you don't have access to all these towers on these levels. In Antidote, you unlock the towers by progressing through the game. So I've already completed all the levels. I have all of the towers. Let's go with something a little bit different here. I'm gonna use Sleepyhead for its secondary function. First, I'm gonna throw down a little bit of sugar generation behind him. Then I'm going to use him to replace these extremely healthy cells on the front line. So, it's fortifying them and it may be 4 or 5 times the health they're getting. But the bacteria are still there and eventually they're going to break through. So let's take care of those bacteria with the snot factory. And let's take care of them with several snot factories. Now this is an example of using the units to devastating effect in combination. This defense line here will hold up to an extremely large number of toxins. It has a serious weakness, which we probably are going to discover in the next level. I know we're going to discover it. Spoiler alert. Alright, level 4. Oh yeah. We're seeing the tutorial on this level. That's very nice of the tutorial. Thanks, Marie. I already know all this. I don't know why you're telling me again, but thank you anyway. Okay, so let's go with the same kind of defense we went with last time, down here at the bottom. And let's see how long it holds up. And let's put the snuff factory here. Cheering me on all the way. Mui is our microscope. She's an intelligent robot. Let's get a new crystal here. That's looking pretty good. And again, see, we're soaking up all the damage in this cell. Oh, thanks, Mui. You're actually going to tell me about something useful. So, this extremely strong cell. Look at that. The virus. It doesn't care. One hit kill. And what's it done? It's turned it into a virus factory. Thankfully there, we see the NK cell on the back line stepping in to clear up. But see what happens if I don't, if I get rid of that. Watch the result. Oh, they're breaking through. No, they're really breaking through. Ah! Okay. So now we have a really quite bad viral infection in this bottom lane. And each one of these factories is producing new viruses. So if I don't keep up with them, they're eventually going to get through here. This is really not a very good strategy. In fact, I'm going to get myself a nurse back on the line. Take care of those infections before they get out of hand. Oh, she's not fast enough on her own. Backup! Need backup! Ooh. So, what I did there was I made life hard for myself, but I also killed a lot more enemies than my previous best, so probably going to get a little bit better score too. Yeah, much better. So that's the kind of dual-sidedness to the game. You can play it how you want, you can go for a big score, or you can go for an easy win. Ooh, we're in the skeleton. Okay. What would you be unlocking here? Were you playing the game for the first time? Sleepyhead. So I showed you Sleepyhead a few levels ago, but level 5 is where you're going to be getting Sleepyhead for yourself the first time. Ooh, I'm on level 5. I said that was only going to play 4 levels. Let's go one more. Just one more level. And there's Mui telling you exactly what I told you. But I'm greedy. I need more sugar. Alright, so I'm going to introduce one more thing in this last level. I'm only going to do one more. I said one more. So, here on the left, we have B-Cell. Now, B-Cell is really awesome on this level. What it does is it's going to take a look at the enemy coming in. Oh yeah, I see you. I see you. Targeting. Targeting. And boom. Antibodies. Now, these are going to be eaten up. Super fast. Just watch the speed that the small eater is digesting. It's one of the most powerful combos you're gonna hit. But I've made a mistake here. This cell, really bad place. If I can put 2 here and not distract. Whoa! Oh! No! No! Whew! Not distract these guys on the front line. And let's put down some. think up here, you know what? We're going to take one more unit. This is Aerosinophil. It's an antibiotic power. So, it's extremely powerful with a massive drawback. So we'll just leave it up there and see if it does anything nasty for us. And let's throw here. What else have we not seen? Ooh, tutorials, yay. We have not seen in action one of my favourite units. It's Plazofil. Ooh, okay, see here in the top left. That bacteria was actually starting to harden. So when a bacteria hardens, if I don't eat it, look at it going. See ya! Getting harder. Okay, now this guy here, just here, let's catch him, is a super bacteria. And he passes that on to all of his friends. So they're all going to be super bacterias now. So, thanks Aerosinophil, GM Antibiotic Tower. If this was a longer level, it would have just ruined my day. Overkill, yeah. Alright, I think that'll do for today. Thanks very much for watching, and next time I'll play some of the later levels of Antidote so you can see me really panic. Thanks very much. Bye.